What's up, everybody? So I just got back a 15 card submission for PSA. This was 7 business days and it took a little over a month to get back, but just happy to get the results back. I got another 15 on the way somewhere. I don't know when I'll get them though. I think that was at 15 business days. And then I got 2 cards that I sent to PSA DNA. But these are the 15 cards that I got back. Just like a lot of submissions that I've done, you have some pretty big disappointments and then some really nice surprises and then a lot of cards somewhere in the middle. So without further ado, I'll just go ahead and get started. And this was without a doubt the biggest disappointment. This was the 1960 Topps Clemente. And as you can see here, it says that it's altered. And I totally, after looking at the card again, I don't know how I didn't notice this the first time. You know, when I look at cards, you know, I'm usually looking, you know, it looks like either look at the corners, the edges. I want to make sure it's authentic. But now that I look at it again, you could clearly see, you know, I think this side looks good, but this side does look like it's been altered. It's possible that, you know, the manufacturer just cut it that way. I have to be honest with you guys, like, this was really disappointing to get back as altered here. You know, I spent an entire show looking for a really nice vintage card about a year ago, and thought I found a really nice card and paid for it like it was a nice card. This may sort of end my, I've been sort of spending a lot of time, you know, looking for vintage cards and, you know, getting them graded, but I just feel like there's too much risk out there with just raw vintage cards. And I feel like I trust people too much. I'm just looking at, now I'm like, when I look at a card, I'm looking, you know, looking at the corners, the edges. I'm not looking to see if somebody altered it or, you know, took like a Sharpie and colored something in, and maybe I should. You know, I just feel like you're better off, you know, for vintage cards, just getting them, you know, already graded. So you're not taking that risk. All right, so anyway, another card that was, and this was a minor disappointment, but this is obviously a Derek Jeter 2012 Topps Chrome Orange Refractor. I'm not really sure why it got a 7 here. Looks pretty nice, but, you know, there's probably some sort of surface issue that maybe is not. Oh, you know what? Now that I'm doing that, you see that? There's like a little dent in the card. Now that I'm doing that, that's funny. So I didn't notice that when I submitted it. Obviously not a big card. Would love to get a PSA 10 on it, but not a huge disappointment there. The next card is this Nolan Arenado. And I actually thought this card would get an 8. And I just, honestly, I wanted to get it graded because I'm a huge fan of Arenado. He was on my fantasy team, and the guy is just, playing obviously in Colorado helps. But I knew that this card had some, I don't know if you'll be able to see it in camera, but there's a little bit of white here. There's white on the corners. I'm not really able to pick it up on the camera, but I thought maybe this would get an 8, so I was actually happy to get a 9 on this card. But just a really, really nice card of Nolan Arenado. Next up, and even though this got a 10, I'm going to actually put it on the side of disappointments, because obviously this is a Luis Severino, and it got a PSA 10, but it was labeled as a Lucas Sims. So I don't know how anyone can confuse Severino for Lucas Sims. But I do understand, you know, they both, if you look at the back of the card, LS, so they both have the same initials, but somehow this managed to pass, quality assurance, with the wrong label. Actually, when it popped, I was, you know, it said Lucas Sims, and I'm like, I didn't submit a Lucas Sims, and then I figured it out. I was like, oh, it must be a Luis Severino. But I figured on the card it would be fine, but then I opened it today and I'm like, oh, you got to be kidding me. It's labeled as Lucas Sims. So obviously I'm going to have to get this fixed, but I'm sure PSA will take care of it. But anyway, PSA 10, hopefully they'll still give it a 10 if I ask to get it relabeled, and they better. Next up is another 10, but this time it's labeled correctly. This is a 2017 Topps Aaron Judge. This is a part, like a short print that's only part of the complete set. It was really cute. My wife and my daughter got me a 2017 Topps complete set for Christmas, and I figured, you know, what the hell, I'll bust it open and, you know, see if there's anything worth submitting, and thought that this card would be a shoe-in for a PSA 10, and sure enough, came back as a really nice PSA 10. Next up is this guy, Yusnil Diaz. He is a top prospect with the Dodgers. Again, guys, you know, I know this isn't a big card, but I figured this card looked, I mean, I was like, this has got to be a 10. So I submitted it, and sure enough, it came back as a PSA 10. So I was really happy with that. And he's, you know, one of the top prospects for the Dodgers. So who knows? Maybe this one day is worth something. But if not, at least it got a PSA 10. And there you have it. Next up is this Gleyber Torres refractor. I remember I pulled this as part of the card crate. I actually have a couple of these particular cards. And this is the only refractor version that I have of this Gleyber Torres. I actually have a couple of this Bowman Chrome 2017, but this is the only refractor version. And again, figured it was, it looked like a PSA 10, so I figured, what the heck, I'll submit it. And sure enough, came back as a PSA 10. Next up, yet another PSA 10. So this is the 2010 Bowman Sterling Madison Bumgarner. I felt like they were being awfully generous by giving me a 10 here. I did not think this card was a 10. Thought this card was a little off center. And once again, I looked at the corners down here. You know, these Bowman Sterling, you know, with the black on the back, sometimes you could see a little bit of white. And especially this corner up here didn't look too good, but whatever, I'll take it. It's a PSA 10. I actually meant to submit this a couple of times, and I passed every single time because I'm like, there's no way this gets a 10. But again, similar to the Arenado, just a huge fan of Arenado. I'm a huge fan of Bumgarner. I think Bumgarner should be up there with the elite pitchers of today, you know, up there with Kershaw. I mean, Kershaw is the regular season guy, but Bumgarner, when it comes to the postseason, there's no starting pitcher out there that I'd rather have on the mound than him. And it's really, really nice to get this back as a 10. And my guess, I should have looked up the pop on this, but I bet you the pop on this card is probably very low. So next up is yet another PSA 10, this time a 2017 Topps Chrome Cody Bellinger. This is a Prism refractor. Again, pulled out of the card crate, not numbered. Last year, about this time, I was, for whatever reason, I fell in love with Cody Bellinger's swing, and I almost bought his Bowman Chrome Auto, and I have regretted ever since then not buying it, because then he went on to have a fantastic year, and I usually don't do that. You know, I've been, like I said, I've been focusing on Yankee prospects when I'm buying my Bowman Chrome Autos, but for whatever reason, I really liked Bellinger's swing, and maybe I'm trying to make up for passing on buying that. And then speaking of Cody Bellinger, here's another one. And yet another PSA 10. This is a 2016 Bowman Chrome Black Gold Refractor. I think I featured this in a previous video. I pulled this actually out of the commons. So who knows when I pulled it. Probably 2 years ago I probably pulled it. And then I threw it in a commons box and then sort of rediscovered it. And you can see here, nice looking card. Again, I thought this would get a 9, but I figured it was worth a shot for, you know, to see if it would get a 10, and sure enough, came back as a 10. Next card up is this. There's a little bit of history with this. You know, got this as sort of a mistake by Topps. Was supposed to redeemed a Steven Strasburg years ago. they sent me the Strasburg, and then for whatever reason, a year or two later, they sent me this Buster Posey auto and figured I'd submit it and came back as a PSA 10. So really cool 1952 Topps throwback and a really nice Buster Posey auto and yet another PSA 10. So the next card up is the Shohei Ohtani Mega Box Refractor. Almost bought this card for $300, a PSA 10, right before, you know, I thought that, I've been saying for the longest time that I thought Ohtani would go to the Yankees, and maybe about 2 weeks before he decided to say no to everybody on the East Coast, I almost bought one of these cards for about $300 in a PSA 10. But instead, I decided to buy the raw version of this card because I figure if you look at the pop report, especially on this card, it's like 99% come back as a PSA 10. So I figure I'll buy it raw for half that price and get it graded. And sure enough, it came back as a PSA 10. So, and there's the other one, by the way. So instead of buying one PSA 10 for $300, I bought, I think these were like 140, 145 at the time. Since then it went down because he didn't sign with the Yankees. He went to the Angels, but I think these cards will go back up, you know, once the hype begins in spring training and then the regular season. It's going to be pretty awesome this year to watch him be a top front of the end, front of the rotation starter, and also sort of, you know, I still haven't really figured out what they're going to do with him. I assume he'll do a little bit of DH, a little bit of, you know, maybe probably sub in for other players throughout the year. Final two cards, guys. At first, this card was a little bit of a disappointment. This is the Stanton X-Fractor in an 8. I didn't think it would get a PSA 10, but I thought it would get a 9. And initially, I was really disappointed. But if you look at the population report on this particular card, most of the X-Fractors have come back an 8. So this is about, you know, the average score. It's like the Ohtani, the average score is a 10. Whereas with this card, the average score is an 8. So it made me feel a little bit better about, you know, getting a lower score on a modern card. So this is numbered to 225. And either way, looks beautiful in the PSA holder. And then finally, guys, without a doubt, the most exciting part of the submission was this card. The Aaron Judge Prospect Auto coming back in a PSA 10 was awesome. And I actually, we flew to Buffalo this weekend. And when we landed in Buffalo, I turned on my phone and turned on the internet and, you know, refreshed the PSA just to see if the cards had popped. And I slowly went through, you know, as we were getting off the plane, I was slowly going through the grades, and I saw the Clemente and the Stanton. But when this Judge popped up as a PSA 10, I was like, yes! And so I was pretty excited, and people on the plane were probably like, what the heck is wrong with this guy? Let's get off the plane as quickly as we can. Pretty awesome result. I mean, this card, you know, getting a PSA 10 on this Judge was worth the entire submission, including the 15 I haven't gotten back yet. And so there you have it, guys. Those are the results on my 15 card submission to PSA. Like I said, I have 15 more that I'm waiting for the results back on, but who knows? I may not get the results back for another month or so. So when they do come in, I will post a video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and obviously let me know if you have any questions. Like, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Peace!